Initially developed to help with calculations, Oak Ridge National Laboratory's early computers were later replaced with supercomputers, and those paved the way for today's Google, Amazon, and artificial intelligence that have transformed our world. Former Oak Ridge National Laboratory Director Thom Mason details the evolution.
Well, computing has been an important part of the way that the labs have done science since the beginning. So if you look at the efforts in the Manhattan Project, the supercomputer was Boy Scouts with adding machines. Coming out of the Manhattan Project in the 50s, there was a big push for more and more powerful computers, and it was actually the nuclear weapons program that was driving that. Oak Ridge had a machine called Oracle that was sort of the supercomputer of the day. And if you looked at what Oracle was used for example, one of the things it was used for was looking at some of those advanced reactor concepts. So there was a thing called a homogeneous solution reactor that was tested out at Oak Ridge. And actually, as a consequence of a leak, they had to close off part of the reactor, and then they had to calculate, will it be safe to run this reactor in a way that's a little bit different than it was originally designed for? They did those calculations on Oracle. And actually, today, with our supercomputers, which are vastly more powerful than Oracle, we do the same sorts of things. We try and numerically integrate formulas that are important for, could be the operations of a nuclear reactor, could be modeling the climate, it could be trying to understand dynamics of materials. So we do all of those things using these massively parallel supercomputers. And more recently, there's another piece. It's now not just the modeling and simulations, but it's also dealing with huge volumes of data and the ability to use what's called machine learning or artificial intelligence to interrogate massive data sets that the human mind could never really get around and extract from that useful information. When you're trying to solve really difficult problems, you've got to be pretty ingenious to come up with new ways to do them. And, computers weren't developed because people thought they wanted to make an Amazon or a Google to, transform the economy. They were developed because they had to do these calculations, and the adding machines just weren't cutting it, and so they had to come up with an electronic way to do that in an automated way, and lo and behold, that turned out to have a much wider range of applications than anyone had ever thought.